What's up, guys? It's been a while, a couple weeks since I made a video. Yes, I still have my contest. Yes, it's closed. I'll do the random sometime this week. It's been the longest. I'm glad it wasn't a subscriber contest, because it's been the longest contest ever. Just had so much stuff pop up in life. Most recently, had to get my daughter tested for COVID. I don't think she has it. I think she has a cold. Just because the school required her to. My wife, myself, and my other daughter don't have any symptoms at all. So it could be allergies. She's got pretty bad allergies. And then, other than that, got a tooth cut out of my face. Finally, I know I've talked about it before. It was shattered down below the gum line. So they had to go in and pull it out and pull all the pieces out. He got the big, you know, the main tooth out pretty easy. Very weird. They hold your jaw and they just wrench back and forth. I don't know if any of you have had one. And then you feel cracking. It's like concrete breaking in your mouth. And then he went and, you know, got the other pieces out. I got 8 or 10 stitches. They're still dissolve. But it's definitely weird. This side's, my jaw on this side's getting very strong because I've only been chewing on this side. I had to eat and drink cold or lukewarm food and meals for 3 days. So like mashed potatoes, yogurt, smoothies. Wasn't fun because I love food, in case you couldn't tell. But it's also opened my eyes on what you actually need in your body. So I know I've been running and biking and stuff, but I do like to eat snacks and treats, but gotta stop sometime. But I'm on the way to work, so that's what I got. I brought it with me because I wanted to get a video done. It's been so long since I've done one. So we'll just get started. These are all mail days. None of these are from care packages, because I would have left those closed. But or trades, not necessarily just care packages, but there's been so much good content. I have been watching and commenting. So much good content lately, guys. There's some video responses I gotta do for contests that are out there. Wade Boggs collector or Wade Boggs fan, I need to do his. There's a couple others, I think, that are out there. But yeah, so gotta get them done. But I bought this lot of Xander Bogaerts. This is from 2013 Topps. This is Bowman. This is a prospect card. There's 5 of them in there. I got those for pretty freaking cheap. $2 or $2.99. And I did combined shipping, so I got that going for me. I got a 2-card lot of Mike Trout. Like I've said before, just doing small PC of him. And I saw this lot. I don't remember what I got it for. Other than those Xanders, I don't remember what I got any of these for. But I don't know what these are called. I'm gonna call them Raptures because I don't know. I wish they would put the name on the back of what they are. But it's from 18 Optic. So we'll go ahead and call that the Silver Wave or Silver Rapture, whatever you wanna call it. And then I got the other one from 18 Optic. So there's both. So it does say Prism on the back, so it's kind of like their refractor mark. But I wish they'd put the name of the insert set on it, to tell you the truth. This one is it's freaking beautiful. God, this thing's awesome. And he sent it in a mag. He sent it in this mag, so it makes it even much better, or even more, not much more better. Much mo better. So we'll see if we can take the cover off to show you. Numbered 6 of 35 out of the new museum collection. Dual patches of Xander and JD Martinez. 6 of 35. Thing's just filthy. I love me some patches. Especially when they're nice and toasty like that one. So, yep. Finally got a CC Auto that I like. I got a different one, and I knew I bought it for a care package for Lou Rock. I gave that one to him. I hope you've all seen that video. If not, go ahead and check it out. But I couldn't keep that one in my collection. I just knew I couldn't because he was in his Yankees uniform. This one's from 2005 from a set that I absolutely adore. I tried doing it. It's a gigantic set. I gave up and I shouldn't have because I gave away a lot of the cards. But 2005 Diamond Kings CC Sabathia auto. And it's got everything going for it. The crooked hat, other than the auto sticker. But it's a good sticker because it's like a cutout for the sticker. And it's number 35 of 50 from the crowning moments. And this is crowning moment is he fanned 11 in 6 innings in a 6-3 victory against the White Sox 2004 for his 10th win. The 6-7 southpaw, it made the 6-7 southpaw the first Indians pitcher to reach double digits in each of his first 4 seasons. Louis Tiant did it in his first 5 seasons from 64 to 68. So really happy to have that one. Again, I got it for a good deal. I know what I paid for that one. This is another 2 cards for the set. These, a guy reached out to me, and funny enough, he lives like 20 minutes from me. Reached out to me on Facebook because he saw one of my posts. These are both have the OC and MC off-centered and miscut markers, but I don't care because they're 8s. So technically they make it a 6, and that's about what I'm collecting. So 68 Topps game, 2 legends, Mr. Rod Carew, and that's got the off-center marker, and then Mr. Al Kaline, rest in peace, and that's got the miscut marker. So those are great for the set. The next, we'll do this one first. This is 2017 Topps. This is the 87 version. Andrew Benintendi, rookie. PSA 9. Love it. And I think I got for like 10 bucks. This next 4 are rookies that I've wanted. And I finally made the purchase thanks to selling my Russell Wilson. So anytime I can sell a modern card and get 4 vintage rookies, I'm going to be super stoked to do. They're not the highest grades. This is a PSA 5 for a 63 Topps. This is Mr. Dick Egan, Julio Navarro, Tommy Sisk, and yours truly, Gaylord Perry. So this is the rookie stars version. I know he has a 62 that's, I think it's a 62 that is just a single picture of him. But I like this one. I like these Brady Bunch style cards. Next up, leave that one for last because that's my big one. This is a SGC 55, 74 Topps. I do have this card raw. I have it. I've had it since I was a kid. I got it in that big collection that I've said before, that me and my dad got, and that'll be in my response for Wade Boggs fan. But I don't have one graded, and this one looks freaking super. It's a little off-centered, and there's a small soft corners on the bottom, very, very lightly soft. But the back color is great. The front color is great. So I don't know exactly if the corners are really what shot it or the little bit of off-centered. But I think it's way better than a 5.5. This thing is clean. Dave Winfield. I mean, the only soft corners they got is that one and that one. And they're not even, the video looks really worse than what it is. They're not that bad. But look at the color on the back. Color on the front. So with it being a 5.5, like Eric always says, buy the card, not the grade. And I got that for a really good price because I bought the card and not the grade. This one also looks really good. It does have some paper stain or whatever you want to call it, or staining down where it says rookie shortstops. But this is from 78 Topps. Back is a little off-centered. Front is a tad bit off-centered, left to right. But Mickey Klutz, UL Washington, with the sweet fro and flat bill hat, and then Mr. Alan Trammell and Paul Molitor, and it's an SGC6, and this does have, so that probably took off a lot, but it doesn't bother me, I don't care. But another Brady Bunch card. Very nice color all around. I've always wanted these four rookies, these four cards I'm showing you. So that's a SGC6. And then this one here is a PSA 6, and I am freaking stoked to have this. It's 1980 top, so I'm sure you already know which one it is. I didn't want to get a 7, 8, or 9, because you really, the difference between a 6 and a 7 to me, this card anyway, they look pretty much the same. And you're paying extra for a 7. I got this for a good deal. I texted a few of you guys. But PSA 6, 80 tops, Ricky Henderson. This card is special to me because, and I've always wanted one. I had one way back in the day that was also in that collection. But I sold it or traded it. I can't even remember what I did with it years ago. But this is special to me because it's one that was in that collection that me and my dad got. And two, it's an 80 tops. And I was born in 80. So, and it's just a sweet card. Got good color, good corners, good centering and everything. I mean, is it the best? No, but it's really the front of it. I think the front of it's freaking spot on almost, little top to bottom. But yeah, so always wanted that card in my collection. Now I have it. And then the last one is a card that I kind of screwed up. I didn't realize it was a big card. And I just saw the number and the color. I'm doing the rainbow of this one, or going to try to, probably minus the 101. But it's 2017 Topps Inception. This one's number 6 of 10. I saw the color and I saw the number. I didn't really read that it was a giant card. So here's how big it is. But it's Chris Sale. So, but I got it really cheap. That's why I bought it. I think I got it for like $3 or something like that. Number 6 of 10. Maybe I'll just frame it, or maybe I'll do the jumbo rainbow. But it's a the yellow. So yeah, that's it. That's what I have for now. But I do have some others coming in, so don't fret. Don't worry, I do have more. and I have another round of care packages going out. I've been enjoying those videos, watching those, you guys open those. That's the best part of this hobby, is just sharing and making people happy. So enjoy, be safe, keep your teeth well. And keep the videos pumping and have a good weekend. All right, guys. See ya.